Hello all, welcome back to iLovePhD. Writing and publishing a research paper is important for an academician, researcher and scientist. Publishing the paper in a reputed journal may fetch you scholarship, funding to carry out R&D projects and makes your profile strong. In this video, you will learn how to write an effective research paper with a sample research paper format. The first step is to select a target journal before start writing your article. It could be easy to shape your manuscript according to journal's requirement. This would increase the chance of accepting your manuscript. After choosing your target journal, start reading the research papers relevant to your work, which are already published in that journal. This can help you to get an idea of the editor's expectation and guide your reading. Use clear and simple language which helps the readers to read and understand easily. Ensure that your present research work is unique and novel from already published works. Write your paper with full confidence to give your reader the hope in your work. Highlighting the need for the study with the support of research gap is very important. Plan a logical sequence of the manuscript and develop ideas precisely. The structure of the research paper is as important as the content itself. It helps the reader to get a clear understanding of your work. Now, let us discuss the format of a typical research paper and how to proceed under each heading in detail. The first page is the title page. The title of a manuscript should indicate the theme of your work. It should be clear, specific, and attractive to the readers to read your paper. We have already discussed on how to choose right title for research paper. I'm giving the link in description box. If you're new, you can refer it. Second thing is abstract. In addition to title that grabs reader's attention, a well-written abstract is important. Abstract is what researchers, scientists, and even journal's editor reads first to identify whether the article is worth reading. The authors must highlight the novelty of the work. The abstract should address the following points. What was investigated in the study? State briefly the specific objectives of the study, why was the study conducted and how was the study conducted, and what are the important findings of the study and what was the significance of the study. These questions are to be addressed or answered in the abstract clearly. Consider rewrite the abstract after finish writing the entire manuscript. Superfluous sentences and irrelevant statements should be avoided. The abstract can also be represented in a graphical format. Some journals mandate to submit a graphical abstract. Then comes the keywords. Keywords should be relevant to your work and it should be easy for the readers to search your manuscript. 5 to 7 keywords are essential. Then introduction. This section of the manuscript should clearly address the significance and impact of your work. Sometimes research on a particular area may be intensively published, so in that case highlighting the novelty of your work is very important. Introduction should have a clear point regarding the advancement or improvement of your field of study and a motivation to carry out your work. Discuss the literatures related to your work and emphasize the research gap identified in your study. You can also present the important literatures in a table format in a chronological order. Based on the research gap, you can frame the objectives of the study. It is suggested to rewrite the introduction once the skeleton of the manuscript becomes clear. Then comes methodology. This section should elaborate on how the research study was conducted in a sequential manner. Methodology includes experimental procedures, sampling techniques, preparation methods, instruments and equipments used, and tools or software used in the study. The readers should get a clear vision on how the research study was carried out by reading this section of your manuscript. Then results and discussion. This is the most important part of a manuscript, and it is all about your research findings and their interpretations. The discussion needs to be beyond the findings, and you need to emphasize more on claims. Interpretation of the results should be explained scientifically, logically, in line with fundamental science and principles. Results can be expressed in any of the formats, namely plots, models, expressions, etc. Remember, the results to be reported in your manuscript should be original, reliable, and reproducible. To support your findings, the results obtained in your study may be compared with the results reported in the literature. And conclusion. This includes the summary of the research findings and overall impression of the study. A good conclusion consists of manuscript's arguments, research outcome, and further scope of study. Conclusion should be strong enough to convince the readers. Then, references. Citing references in appropriate place is important and necessary in order to avoid plagiarism. When you cite a reference, make sure that you understand its relevance to your work. References should be listed at the end of the manuscript as per your chosen journal's referencing style. Then acknowledgement. Here you can submit a brief acknowledgement of any financial instrumentation and academic support you received during your research work. And this is how a typical research paper looks. And we have discussed what is expected in each heading. Now it is time for revision. So it is good to get feedback from your mentor and fellow scholars. Verify all sections have fulfilled its purpose. And for grammar, sentence structure, and results reported, like number check and the decimal points are correct and accurate. And finally, once you have made necessary revisions, your paper is now ready for submission. So the take-home message of this video is, the strongest research papers generally have two or three strong points to make. You need to register those points powerfully with your results and suitable evidence. Remember, each step in research writing a research paper is essential for a well-structured paper that contributes to your field of study. Thank you.